for the 7 of you who tuned in while I get my act together. Actually, I'm just doing a test with the internet bandwidth. I just increased my bandwidth with new modem in the whole 9 yards, so now it's just a matter of making tweaks to the stream. I know that sometimes when the movement starts to pan around, things get a little gibbered and pixelated, so I'm hoping that with the increase in bandwidth, especially on the upload, that the quality will look a little bit better. At least that's my hope. So, for those of you who are tuning in now, any feedback that you're able to provide would be very valuable. Alright, so first up is Sim720's Augusta, which was released today, as a matter of fact, earlier this morning. I was actually a little bit slow on news today because today happens to be an off day for me, so I got to sleep in a little bit. Let's take a look at the frame rates here. Frame rates are in the 40s, so that's good, but I am noticing some micro stutters, especially as I pan around. Okay. Once again, we're airborne in a helicopter, as that's the best way to survey sceneries. And a little bit more exciting than just slewing around, of course. I have to say, Augusta, Georgia is, I don't want to go so far as to say as this is an unusual destination for flight simulation. I'm sure it's probably been covered in freeware in the past, but for a payware destination, it's actually quite nice to see developers going into some of these smaller regional airports, especially for the U.S. We've seen a lot of regional airports in Europe, which happen to be quite popular, especially in Germany and the U.K., but not so much the U.S. And Augusta, Georgia is probably a little bit off the beaten path in terms of popularity. So I do wonder why they chose this airport. I think up until now, there's a development team called the Airport Guys, and they've been mostly focusing on this region of the world, or at least in the U.S. So it's nice to see more airports in this area. Let's get down and take a look at the texture quality a bit. Now, one of the things I've noticed with Sim 720 is they have been progressively getting better quality-wise with each release. I would probably say that one exception is Santa Barbara, and I will only say in regard to that it has some pretty tough performance issues. I believe they worked out those issues with the latest update, but I never got it, so I haven't been able to retest it with a new update. But one of the things that Augusta here has in common with Santa Barbara is this sort of two-dimensional interior modeling effect that they're using. And I think they went this route more or less in an effort to, as opposed to maybe doing sort of 2D texture baking windows or photoreal, or not having the time or the ability to do full interior modeling. They've sort of gone with these 2D imagery and then placing them behind the windows. And of course, the windows do have the specular shine and reflection. And so they've basically added these two-dimensional images inside the building as opposed to full interior modeling to give you something that's a bit more of just looking at texture baking, but not full interior modeling. And Sim 720 is the first to do this. So a little bit of innovation from them. Looks like I just got a crash to desktop. Not really sure why that is, so your screen's going to go black for a second while I reload the simulator. That's not very good. In fact, I might want to shut down some background programs here. The product also comes with a control manager, which adds a lot of features to the airport as well. I use a program called System Mechanic that basically allows me to shut down, search and shut down a lot of programs that I don't necessarily need right now. And that'll free up some performance. Not that it's necessary with this computer, but nevertheless, it's better to just get that stuff out of the way. I'll do some more panning. Yeah, I'm getting a little bit of feedback that the panning... Actually, I was seeing some stutters with the panning here as well. So I actually think that might be the scenery. So we'll try it again. I've got to wait for it to load back up here. Yeah, ID is talking about prepared V2.3. Yeah, that can't come fast enough. I guess that's one of the most exciting things about prepared is that there are updates constantly being worked on and released, and that's always something great to look forward to. I mean, if you go back and think about FS9, when that first came out, Microsoft only released one update for it, and that was like a couple of years after it was released. It was like some, maybe not that long, but I know it was significant. There was a significant amount of time that lapsed after it was actually released, before the first update came out, and then after that we never actually saw another update. And then with FSX they came out with Acceleration and Gold, which were essentially updates, I guess you could say, and then they sort of disappeared, and that was it. So we've already essentially have seen more updates coming from Lockheed Martin with prepared than FS9 and FSX combined, and you could probably add FS2002 and FS98 on that list as well. So that's a great thing about prepared, is not only are they going in and fixing a lot of issues that arise, but of course they're adding new cool features and stuff too. So yes, in answer to your statement, Adi, definitely I'm looking forward to 2.3 as well. But I do get smooth panning with many sceneries in aircraft. Usually when it's stuttery, that means there's something in the scenery that's causing stutters, or like AI traffic and stuff like that. But for an airport this small, we shouldn't be seeing that. But what I want to know, though, is not so much if you're seeing stutters. What I want to know is if you're seeing pixelation when I pan around. So I think we can agree we're both seeing stutters, but what I'm more or less looking for is if the screen becomes garbled and pixelated when I do quick movements or panning around, because that's really gonna give me an idea if I need to make more adjustments to the broadcasting software. All right, we're back again. Sorry it took so long. And Sensible, I don't know how to pronounce that. Can you give me some advice on how to properly pronounce your screen name, please? So at least I know how to refer to you guys. It could have been the helicopter I was using before too, but I am still noticing some slight stutters panning around. Yeah, it's definitely not super smooth. Let me pull up the frames here for the benchmark. Frame rates, still in the 40s. So anywhere from, looks like, what, The lowest I'm seeing is 38, highest is 51. Is that like a building in the background? Just one tall tower in the middle of nowhere? So this is prepared V2.2. If Lockheed wants to send over a 2.3 beta, I'd be more than happy to check it out. So before we lost our connection, we were taking a look at the sort of two-dimensional interior modeling that the SM-720 guys have added to the scenery. And it looks like they've added static aircraft too, because these definitely do not look like my AI. The blues on Delta are a little too blue. So yeah, these CRJs here look like statics. They're actually nice looking statics, not bad as far as statics go. And looking at the texture work on the hangars look really nice too. I am noticing some stutters though. I mean, high frame rates, but stutters. Some nice detail with air conditioners and some static people down there. I have to be careful not to call it people flow, because naturally that's an Orbix trademark. It's a nice Saab static model there. So getting back over to the firehouse, which has nice trucks on the inside, which is good. We were talking about this two-dimensional interior modeling that SIM-720 is doing. And so far, they're the first to sort of come up with this idea, which sort of gives you an effect that you can see inside the building by way of using two-dimensional imagery, which I think is pretty innovative. I think it'll definitely save time throughout the production. Still give you sort of that interior modeling feel, and probably lighter on frame rates. Although, so far, all the developers that I know that are doing interior modeling, they've managed to be able to do it with very little to no performance impact, especially in the case of Flight Beam Denver or L8 Simulations Budapest. Those are two examples. So I guess my question to you guys would be whether or not you sort of like this two-dimensional look that they're doing here. I actually think it looks nice. Obviously, it's not as nice as full blast interior modeling, but I certainly think it's something cooler than sort of texture baking windows. It's an interesting alternative to photoreal. And that's essentially what it is. It's still photoreal imagery inside the building. Or rather, photoreal interior imagery, I should say. Oh, okay, I'm coming in around here a little too fast. Ooh, this is not good. Ouch. Okay, let's take a look around the front. I think I would go so far as to say that this is SIM-720's nicest work to date. In fact, let me get into a position where we can kind of slew around and get a better look at it. Give me just a second. I have to activate FSUI PC so I can kind of cruise us out of the virtual cockpit. And one of the things I did notice during the development of this airport, even though the airport came pretty quick after the initial previews, is that they didn't give us too many previews of the airport. There weren't a whole lot. And they, with the previews that we did get, they were sort of photoshopped. So, and what I mean by photoshopped is around the edges. So it wasn't full crisp imagery. So that's why I'm sort of taking the time to get this look now for you guys while testing the bandwidth, so you can just get a look for yourself, sort of the bigger picture. So, and it looks like this is the first airport I think I've seen with motion people. I think maybe they did it in Santa Barbara as well. Now here we have full 3D interior modeling here. So On some of the other buildings, they sort of went the route of the 2D imagery, and but with the main terminal, they certainly went 3D. Sorry, I'm trying not to pan around too fast here, but it's very sensitive. Got carts with luggage on it and a couple of people just walking around in circles. This guy looks like his back hurts. This guy over here is waving us over. Yes, sir. What can I do for you, sir? Get out of my face! Okay, alright. Alright, let's head back out onto the ramp. Now, out here looks like we have a lot of these static jets. So, with the interior modeling with the main terminal here, I think actually that was a very good idea, and certainly a nice effect as well. And in my opinion, this just really shows the differences between having windows that would be either texture baked or with the use of photoreal imagery as opposed to full interior modeling. I think the interior modeling just gives it a much more realistic feel, especially when you're in the 3D cockpit. Because of course, even though you're in the middle of programming, you're still going to wind up looking out the window. I mean, that's inevitable from the cockpit. So to look around and actually be able to see into the terminal across from you and people moving around in there, that's what you would see in real life. So why not in the simulator, of course? And if it doesn't affect performance, then I think that's a great thing. I'll just take a quick look over and see if anyone had any comments. Adi is saying that Sim720 is improving, still far from Orbix. Well, quite natural. If I'm not mistaken, and I could be wrong, so don't fully take my word on this here, but if I'm not mistaken, Sim720's position at Orbix was, I think, to develop the FTX England sceneries, if I'm not mistaken. More to the point, I think it was to develop the region, or rather the regions, not so much the airports, if I'm not mistaken. So I think what once Sim720 went on their own, I think they went more or less from doing the regions to doing actual airports. So I think there is some trial with the quality of the airports in terms of now being a full scenery developer or development company. And like I said, I think the quality of the work has been going up quite a bit. Again, the only thing that I took any issue with as of recent is just Santa Barbara. There are some things with Santa Barbara that I feel could have been done better, but I still haven't gotten the update yet. I did request it, but I haven't gotten it yet. But everything else that they released, with the exception of the East Faroese Islands, I haven't been able to get a review of that yet. But with the exception of that, all their work is pretty good. And I've done reviews on all of them, with the exception, of course, the East Faroese Islands and Santa Barbara. And I'll say, so far, this is definitely their best work. I think one area that they need to work on is with the foliage, if you will. The grass, I really don't like the look of the grass. I really don't. I feel like that's definitely one area that can be improved. I mean, certainly if you look at some of the stuff that Orbix is doing, it looks a lot better. So I would like to see some improvement in that area. I mean, as far as the ground texturing work is, I think the ground textures are pretty nice. The building textures with the brick are nice as well. The trees are actually nice. The cars in the lot are very interesting, but they definitely went with cars that are reflective of America. I mean, I don't know if anyone's driving Nissan GTRs into Augusta Airport, but some of these older cars and Dodge trucks are certainly more reflective of the region. Camaros and so on and so forth. So, parking lot full of cars, which is always a good thing. That's what I like to see. But overall, I mean, as far as the appearance and texture quality, I think this is definitely their best airport to date. I mean, I think the quality looks very good. And so far, the frame rates are pretty high as well, except for a little bit of stuttering here and there. Ben Kep, welcome aboard. He says he thinks he saw Arnold Schwarzenegger in there. Oh, God. Now we're going with the request for Arnold Schwarzenegger again. Goodness. So, very interesting when it comes to interior modeling. I know once I did the post about Russ White's MBS scenery, there was a lot of negative feedback in regards to interior modeling. And I actually got a look at some more sneak peeks today. And I have to tell you, and this is coming from me, if any of you have ever read any of my reviews, was this another room? If any of you have ever read any of my reviews, and if you've ever agreed with any of my reviews in terms of my opinion on products, and when I say I think something looks good, if you agree with it, then I'll just say this. Based on some of the previews that I've seen of Russ's MBS today, it's so far, it's shaping up to be probably the best thing that I've ever seen. So that's all I'll say at the moment, but it's incredible. The level of detail, the level of quality is incredible. In fact, it's surpassing that of Flight Beam right now. The only difference, of course, being that Flight Beam is into developing mega airports. But that's just how good the quality is. It's extremely impressive. So, unfortunately, I can't share with you any of those, but when the next set of preview images come up, I think you'll be very impressed. Sorry, I'm having some trouble slowing around here. I think I'll use the keys instead of the joystick. And I think Sim720 has really captured the look and feel of this airport perfectly. I really do. I think they've captured it perfectly. And when you look at the architecture, it's almost sort of easy to determine why they chose this airport. I mean, it is. It's definitely something different. It really is. I guess just the interesting thing about Sim720 is they are not confining themselves to any specific country or city or region. They're all over. From Catalina Island here in Southern California to Wales, Scotland, England, they're all over. So, and now Georgia. And I have to say, this one really caught me off guard just because I didn't expect them to go in this direction. And I think the work is quite impressive. I mean, and that's quite a bit of glass there too, isn't it? So, I've got one jet bridge there. I couldn't tell you if there's any way that thing can be animated or not, unfortunately. I think the only downside with some of these static AI, and I believe in the control manager, I think you can remove some of the AI aircraft, but I think I would have liked to have probably had them park these two somewhere else, because I can imagine right in front of the terminal glass there's probably where I would want to park, where the US and the Delta CRJs are. Park right up to the glass there. That's likely what I would do. I'll take a minute and look at your comments. If there's any feedback on the internet in terms of the quality of the picture, definitely let me know. Static shadows. Are these static shadows, Adi? I don't know. Let me see here. I don't think these are static shadows, are they? Oh, yeah, I think you're right. I think they are. I don't know. They don't really bother me at all. I'd have to change the direction of the sun to know for sure. Whoa! Boosh! Crash right through the terminal. So now that I'm no longer slowing, I can see the stuttering has come back a little bit. I can only try to guess at to what's causing that stuttering. I'm just going to go to a higher altitude and take a look at the photo imagery. So I can say, looking at the sides of the runway, it's definitely a small runway. I'm pretty sure, though, that you could use an NGX here. Obviously, this is a runway that would probably best serve regional airlines, but I'm sure you could get an A320. Probably not fully loaded, though. That runway looks a little bit too short to probably try to land a fully loaded A320 or 737. And this is the compatibility with FTX Global Vector surrounding the airport. And of course, I think it's fairly easy to see the airport boundaries here. So I think it blends fairly well. If you have other meshes and land class sceneries for the area, there is an option within the control panel to check compatibility with those. Especially if you're one of those who prefer the just the photo terrain. It's like I get the feeling this airport's sort of out in the middle of nowhere, but even myself, I'm trying to think, what would I fly here and from where? This is Georgia, so you've got Imagine Sim Atlanta not too far away. You have Fly Tampa. If you go into Florida or FSDT Fort Lauderdale, that's much further south though. Besides that, you have Reagan from Tropical Sim, and then of course you start getting into the New York areas. Not too many airports in this part of the world. And of course I mentioned the airport guys, and they have done quite a few sceneries in this area too. So I think they actually did the heart of Georgia airport, so that's probably a nice short flight, maybe with a Q400. Doing a quick descent here. Ah, I'm gonna crash! Oh, let's let it crash. Bounce. There we go. Okay. So that's it. A very small airport. But given its size, I think it's well done. Obviously, you're not going to have any issues with frame rates, but you might have some issues with some micro stutters. In fact, I'm going to get right over the airport and try to pan around a little bit again. So the good, I guess the good thing about doing some of these smaller airports is the fact that they're quick. They're a lot quicker than doing larger airports, and I think that's what enables Sim 720 to release now their 13th airport since they went into business on their own. And so far, all of their airports have been regional airports, not general aviation airports, with the exception of the East Region Islands. Those are all GA airports, but they released, I think, 6 or 7 airports in that package. I'm just going to pause and kind of do some panning around here. Yeah, you can definitely see that there's some stuttering. It doesn't affect the performance at all. I mean, I'm starting to see frames in the 60s, but with the performance, I mean, with the stutters, that can be something of an issue. And that's kind of the new thing now. I think back in the day, we were always concerned about frame rates. Now it seems like sceneries are getting higher in frame rates, but now they're coming with these sort of micro stutters that are annoying. Greg's asking, is this where the Masters Golf Tournament is? I know something takes place. There's some major sporting event that does take place in Augusta. I know that for sure. It might be golf. Golf. But I'm not 100% sure. So that's pretty much it. Not too much to show. It's a small airport, but at least now you get a little bit more of what was offered with the screenshots that they published. Someone mentioned, I mentioned the airport, the airport guys already. I saw another one. MYR, I'm trying to think what MYR is. What airport is that? Who put that there? Dab spotting, I'm trying to think what MYR is, and I saw another one, CLT. What developers put those together, guys? Yeah, the blue on the static CRJ there is a little too blue. Besides that, they used the wrong Delta widget too, as well. That's actually no longer the official logo, if I'm not mistaken. I don't remember seeing the red and blue widget on the new Delta planes. I think it's just the red one now, isn't it? I don't know, for some reason the widget and the font looks off to me. It looks like it's from the older livery. But yeah, the blue is quite blue. And of course, the older US Airways livery, too. I like what they did with the brick wall here. That's pretty nice. right, so I guess that's pretty much it with this one. This will be a fairly simple ADX first look for me to write up. And again, I think this is their best one to date. I have personally tested everything that they've released since they've branched out on their own, and I can definitely say this is their best one so far. Oh, Myrtle Beach and Charlotte, yeah. In fact, I think we do have those in our account somewhere, so I might download them and do some short sorties, maybe with the Q400, maybe something from Atlanta. So, interesting location, especially from Sim720, but a nice one. And looking at the architecture, it's sort of this southern colonial style architecture. I think it looks very nice. I think they did a great job implementing it into the simulator, and I think they went the right way by using interior modeling, especially because this airport has a lot of large glass windows. So it, in my opinion, it makes sense. I guess this guy is sneezing. Alright, so I guess that's pretty much it with this airport. Again, it's very small, so there wasn't much to show, and ultimately what I needed to do was test the bandwidth. So if there is no complaints with the quality, in fact I might pull up just a different airport just to test the panning around without the micro stutters here. I just want to make sure that that's, if it's scenery or the connection. So your screen's going to freeze up just a minute while I load it up. We can listen to those Jetline super fans cooling things down. Okay, so what I want to run is just a quick test with the panning around. In fact, I might need to restart the simulator just because of the changing of the scenery here. No, even here I can see that the panning looks like it's a little bit better. There's some stutters. But if anyone who's watching now, if you can just tell me when I do this fast panning around, does the screen pixelate as opposed to when it's still? Sometimes when it's still, the image becomes crystal clear, and then when I pan around, it tends to pixelate a bit. So I'm just wondering if anyone can give me any feedback on that really quickly. So I do know that it is stuttering a bit, but I'm more or less concerned about the pixelation. Okay, so one bit of feedback there. I'll take your word for it. All right, so I think I'm going to go ahead and sign off. Before I do, I'll ask if there's anything that anyone wanted me to preview before I do. So if not, then I'm going to go ahead and sign off. Still have quite a bit of work to do updating the review sections and the billboard. So I'm going to try to get that done today. But while I'm here, if there's anything anyone wanted me to take a look at for them, I'll wait just a few seconds with the delay. Otherwise, I'll go ahead and sign off. Thank you, Greg. Appreciate it. Okay, guys, so if that's it, thanks for tuning in and checking out the Augusta Airport, and I'll make sure that that's available on the main page as well for anyone who missed it, or if you want to go back and watch it again, I'll make sure that's available for you guys to check out, and hopefully I can get the first look on this one as well as a few others that I'm behind on sometime next week. Other than that, always good to have you guys hang around. And until next time, signing out. Cheers.